Hello and welcome to this week's pick segment for high school. As you know, I took Jessica Schambach down last week, winning by 2 games. I was 6-5, and she was, I think, no, I was 7-4, and she was...
That was not a takedown.
5-6.
That was not a takedown. I'm calling for a Florida recount. Okay?
It looked good. It was a Florida type situation. You looked good early in the night, but you came back, and I came back to win. So it was.
You're gonna need this, buddy.
Will you please plug our sponsor, Gilbert and Sons Trucking in Tecumseh?
These hats are. They are.
They look good. They look good. We would like, and we know you're a busy guy, have very important things to do. We'd like to present you with a Nebraska helmet as a token of our gratitude, as well as
you
will be receiving a fabulous prize pack in the mail, including a Channel 5 denim shirt. I haven't seen you with these on remote location.
I haven't had denim in a while. That looks good.
This is certainly something good to rake a yard with, or, if you're ever outside doing a remote, then we give that to you.
So
we'll have our people get in touch with your people.
Come on this show a lot sooner had I known I was going to get all these goodies.
Now, I know you've been attending high school football games this year, so you're going to be a worthy adversary.
I've seen McGinnis play twice, so I feel like I'm in the know.
Would you like to look at the games?
You throw them at me, and I'll just use my divine powers.
We're going to build up to the game of the week, which is Bridge Creek and Bethany.
Oh, yeah.
This week at Bethany. All right, first game, Midwest City and Norman, Thursday night game. It is the Bombers against the Tigers.
Oh, wow. Midwest City, Norman. I'll go with Norman.
You're going to go with Norman. Well, that would be an upset, Mr. Mitchell.
Yes, who was the guy from Midwest City back in the mid-90s? Running back?
Vernon Maxwell.
Yes.
Vernon Maxwell.
Since Vernon left, I got to go with Norman.
Okay, Norman coming off a win last week at Choctaw. Midwest City had that big win over Edmond. The Bombers are undefeated. I'm going to go with Midwest City here, and I think they continue their role. How about Edmond and Lawton Ike?
Oh, Lawton Ike.
I agree with you. I think Lawton Ike. At home, though, Edmond's playing better football this season so far. They're off to a good start. They had that four-point loss last week to Midwest City. Pete Towne, quarterback, throwing the ball well. I know you're a native of Edmond. I hope they don't TP your yard over this deal.
I lived there once. I had to move away.
Okay. Let's go with Jinx and Muskogee. Not in our viewing area, but a game still of epic proportion.
You would think Jinx. One just thinks Jinx. I'm thinking Muskogee. Muskogee is a state powerhouse on the east side. Maybe not the Jinx level, but I'm going with the upset.
I feel you on the upset. I think that's certainly a possibility. It's at the Indian Bowl in Muskogee. They're going to be ready for the Trojans to come to town, but I'm going to go with Jinx.
Okay.
I think they have just
That's the easy pick.
A little bit too much.
I expected that out of you.
I feel myself getting hot. Last week wasn't so good. Moore and Mustang at Mustang.
I'm going to go with... I'll go with the home team. I'll go with Mustang.
I'm going to go with Moore.
Okay.
I think this is another you pick 'em game. Moore is getting healthy. Mustang had a couple of bad games at the beginning of the season, but they're getting their offense in check. And
they got that out of their system now.
You're exactly right. All right, Putnam City at Choctaw.
I'm gonna go with PC.
I think PC is always the way to go. It's always good to be PC. They're undefeated as well.
Yeah.
I think one of the top teams in the state. We could have two undefeated teams come together in week 10 of the season, Putnam City and Midwest City. If that happens, would you agree to go to the game with me?
Heck yes.
Oh, I like that.
I'm there.
I'll be rolling Lars there. Stillwater at Dell City.
Ooh. This is a hard one.
This is a tough one. I agree with you.
I'm going to have to think about this. Stillwater at Dell City. Let's go with the home team, Dell City.
Dell City has a great chance to beat Stillwater. I think that Dell City
It would be an upset?
It would be a I think it would be an upset, but I don't know that I might not agree with you.
You don't have to.
It's very tempting for me to take Dell City, but I wouldn't want to steal Rick's upset thunder there, so I'm going to go with the Pioneers.
Okay.
You know, the Pioneers.
Sure.
Here's the thing, is that the Pioneers used to travel from Stillwater to Dell City in a stagecoach.
Mm-hmm.
Now they travel in an air-conditioned bus with DVDs and television. So I think that's going to be the difference, that the technology will get them over the top.
I never had air conditioning or DVDs as a kid.
Neither did I. DVDs.
School bus, bouncing around.
It's a great thing.
Yeah.
UConn at Westmore. This is another you pick 'em.
Westmore.
UConn, they keep impressing me every week. I picked against them last week. Jessica Schambach, she knew about UConn. She took the Millers. So I'm going to go against them one more week. I picked UConn at the beginning of the season. I've got some thank you notes from that, and I really appreciate that. But
nice.
Lawton, Mac, and Duncan. That game is at Duncan.
I'm going to stick with the Lawton theme.
Mm-hmm.
Go with Lawton, Mac, just like I did with Lawton, Ike, and Hal.
I'll take Lawton, MacArthur as well.
Okay.
Those are both generals, right?
They were.
MacArthur.
Yeah. Good ones,
yes.
Too.
McGinnis at
Why don't we have a Lawton patent? If Lawton... If Lawton ever has another high school, it could be Lawton.
If they had a fourth high school, I think that's what it should be. That's very good. What about General Washington?
Yeah, he's all right.
Was he? It's been a while. Steve. You're only as good as what you've done lately.
Do the World War II stuff.
McGinnis at Weatherford.
I've got to go with McGinnis.
I agree with you. Are you an adopted McGinnis fan?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And I've seen him last couple weeks, and very impressive.
All right, big rivalry. The Racers and the Tigers, Tuttle, Newcastle. A lot of people, southwest Oklahoma City, outside there will enjoy. I was in Tuttle this morning, by the way. I'll say hi to Jeff Williams.
Yeah, Jeff's a good guy.
Yes, he is.
Just because I met Jason White recently, I'm just based on that, I'm going with Tuttle.
Well, that's lucky that you met Jason White, because if he was from Newcastle, I think you'd be on the wrong side.
Right,
of
this. Right.
So, I'm going to take Tuttle. I think the Tigers are the best team in Class 3A. Clinton or Tuttle, and that game is Week 9. So we're already setting up the game of the week coming up for later in the year. All right, our game of the week, Bridge Creek, undefeated. Bobcats 5-0. Bethany, the Broncos, 4-1 at Bethany.
5-0 versus 4-1.
5-0 versus 4-1.
You know, I've been taking a lot of the home teams. I think I'm going to have to go with Bridge Creek here.
Bridge Creek. You're going with Bridge Creek.
Yeah.
I'm going to go with Bethany.
Okay.
Bethany is a title contender in 2A, but it's a huge step-up game for Bridge Creek. If they can show that they can beat Bethany, then this would lead them maybe to their best season. They're already almost the best season in school history. They only had one winning record. Only been to the playoffs once. And so this would clinch their sixth win and a winning record. Will you do something for me real fast here? All right, I appreciate that.
Victories than Jessica Shambach did.
You're well on your way to that. Would you like to plug the pigskin preview?
Yearbook.
Yeah.
If you want to know everything that there is to know about high school teams, I was looking at McGinnis in here and what you had said about them.
Exactly.
And this man knows everything. Where can you find these?
You can find these just about anywhere where you find, like my friend Jeff Williams.
Yeah.
He's in Tuttle. As a matter of fact, I have a manifest here of his stores. Williams Grocery number 20 in Tuttle, Elgin, Midwest City, Dell City, Barnes & Noble.
Yeah, Barnes & Noble?
Oh, yeah. You can find them anywhere you can find magazines. And if not, just email me here, sports@koco.com, and that's fine. You know, and really, for my favorite email of the week, we will also send one of these luxurious denim shirts. Very fashionable. Back in 1993.
Yeah. But early to mid 90s.
Yes. But so it's never too late, and we might be towards the backside of this coming back around into fashion.
That's right. Yeah.
So I think Matt Laws bought this, which is okay. All right. That was a legitimate laugh, by the way. We'll see you on Friday night.